Getting a new machine for the workshop is always something I really like. Unpacking, installing, and those first days of testing are the moments I enjoy the most. But the turn side of getting new equipment is that it's also another thing that needs to be organized, maintained, and cleaned. I've learned that if you don't organize your tools, and especially if you don't organize your most used tools, that you don't own your tools, but your tools own you. The moment I got this realization looked something like this. I just finished some G-code and I was looking forward to start my project. The first thing I couldn't find was my tape measure. Then I discovered my parallel set to be incomplete. Wrench number 10 has to be somewhere nearby. And which of these 20 collets is the 1/8-inch version I need? At this time, my excitement for the project was gone. I was annoyed with working with my CNC and I almost wanted to call it a day. But a voice in my head said, "Come on, you can do better than this." I took all my tools that I had gathered around my CNC and first started to remove everything that wasn't frequently used. Every tool that was left went in the top drawer. And all the end nails and collets in the second drawer. I'm going to deal with the vise and the T-slot clamps another time. To make custom drawer inserts for each tool, I scanned every tool with a photo scanner. Now the pictures can be uploaded to Fusion 360. When the picture is in Fusion 360, you can correctly scale it by adding one known dimension, in this case 22 mm. Then you only have to trace the contour, and then you end up with something like this. I'm going to use a 3 mm end mill for both operations. First we're going to make a hole straight through the board for the ratchet key. After that we're going to do the pockets that are only 10 mm deep. This part takes a good 2 hours. For the collets and the end mills, I designed these small tool holders. I made 4 extra holders that I can use for when my tool collection grows. Here we're going to start with the pockets for the collets and then the bigger end mills. Then a drilling pattern for the small end mills, and we finish with the contour of each holder. I left 4 small tabs on every holder so they don't break loose during the milling operation. In total, this takes around 45 minutes. And the final operation is a drawer that holds the tool holders. I'm going to use an 8mm end mill that takes a 10mm depth of cut at full width. And this takes around 15 minutes.